Alright, this is going to be a tutorial on, not a tutorial, but a little demonstration on how I like to do my Tyranids. I prefer to do a method of all wash. It's become a technique I've become really fond of. Especially with horde armies, you can really spend a lot of time trying to paint these models. And if you're doing them in regular pigment, it just takes forever. And I found this technique of all wash gives you a really unique look, kind of organic, as opposed to the hard armor look of like a space marine. And it gives you a lot of flexibility to do different things with it. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. I like to do a very interesting kind of paint scheme with mine. So we're gonna be starting with a Druji Violet, and Null Oil. Tervigon has been covered in all purple. It's been a couple days of drying, as you may have heard in my other video with the Blood Angel that I was working on. A couple days spent doing other things, and he could get back to doing this. But now we're going to move on to start doing really the carapace portions of this Tervigon here. And we're going to be covering the orange portions of the purple portions of the carapace, and we're going to be using Null Oil again. Starts kind of the pool in certain areas. We want that. We want that pooling to happen. It's gonna leave darker pockets for us to work with. Okay, we are back with our Tervigon. The black has dried. And what we're gonna do, so far we've done purple all over and black on the carapace. Now we're gonna go back over that carapace again with some more purple. So what our eventual theme is gonna go purple, black, purple, and black. Now right now you're not seeing much of a differentiating between the carapace and the rest of them. But as we start getting these layers on, and as they start to dry out, you're going to really see the difference in the carapace to the rest of the body. Black has had an opportunity to dry, and we're going to come back in with another layer of purple. Oh, I'm sorry, we actually did our second layer of purple, and we're going to come back at it with another layer of black. So I can see our purple has now dried on top of our black, and you can see how much darker the carapace is getting than the rest of the body. And so now we're going to move into another layer of black on the carapace and the claws. We'll be right back. that last coat of black in there. We'll let that sit and we'll see how that comes out as soon as it dries. Okay, and now we are back to our Tervigon. You may hear my son in the background playing, but that's okay. This is a family affair that I do here. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to start the dry brushing and the highlighting of our Tervigon. We've got all of the black carapace that we're looking for. As you can see, I don't know if the camera can catch it, but we've got lots of good variation between the black and the purple. It's multi-tonal, and it's a really good look. So that's kind of what we're going for. It's what I have in all my Tyranids. Get lots of good compliments on it, and that's why we do this. Just get compliments on our models. So we're going to take a bright silver here, and we're going to start by dry brushing that all over the raised edges of our model. And get a little bit of pigment, not a lot, on our flat shader brush. Sun's messing around with the camera. And what we do is we take that pigment and kind of brush a little bit off on our towel here, and then we just start brushing. And we're just going to brush up against the grain of the carapace here. Just lightly dusting it. Show you what I'm doing and how I make it get that dry brush on there. So what I do is I have my paint here and I dip a little bit into it like that. And what I do is I grab my rag here and I just brush it off into there. Make it nice and dry. Give this dry layer. Now there'll be paint on the inside of the bristles, but it won't be all over the edge of it. You can just okay, now the dry brushing is done. We're gonna move on to our detail portion of the model. We're gonna start putting in our green over our purple. We're gonna use a little moot green today. And my pot is a little funky and it likes to spread paint everywhere. We're gonna use a super fine tip, round brush here. And we'll start putting in our detail greens in the carapace and around the carapace to really get that good contrast of colors going on. Go right on top of the areas of silver that we put in. We'll be right back. color in behind the carapace here. And it gives you that bright green hit in the back. And it'll become kind of hidden in there, but you'll see it as the thing starts to move. It gives kind of a multi-tonal effect on the model. Okay, and we are back to this Tervigon. See, we've got all of the green highlights on there. What we're going to do now is we're going to use some contrast with that dark purple, and we're going to hit that with something a little brighter to really make it stand out. So we're going to use a little Warlock purple. It's an older color from Citadel. There's a newer version of it, but we're going to start with that.